Hello everyone and welcome back to some more Code Vein. Today I'm going to be showing you all the quickest way to go out and get yourself some Queen Steel and Tungsten. So, right now I'm pretty much at endgame, like just before, but this isn't a guide straight away, but it will help not too far into the game. By the time you're up to the Crown of Sand here, there are enemies there that I will show you that you can farm titanium from. But by the time you're up to the Provisional Government Outskirts, which the Crypt Spire isn't very long whatsoever, but it is one of the more difficult areas. By the time you're up to this point, you'll be able to infinitely farm anything you need in this game. So by the point that I'm up to now, once you've gotten to the Provisional Government Center, you'll be able to come over here to Coco and talk to her. Buy items from her.
I got it.
And you can see here I have Queen Iron, Steel, and Titanium all available for 2k or less infinitely.
Go out there and
the best way to get Haze that I have found. Also, if you guys want to see my build, I will be doing build videos. But the best way that I have found is to go out to the Provisional Government Center here. You want to go to the entrance, and there's an enemy here. By this point, you should definitely either have or be able to unlock Revenant's Hunger. This helps out a little bit too with it. But I found the easiest way is to come here with a partner, and there is a Urgent Wolf Guard here, who is near a couple other enemies, but he's pretty easy to take down, and every time you kill him, you get just over 19k haze, and that will be enough to buy you almost 5 clean titanium at once, just back to back to back. But after I show you this, I will also show you a location you can go to and just farm that way as well. So now that we're here at the Provisional Government Center, you're just going to want to go past this dead body over here, and there he is. He's got a pretty wide aggro range, so you can easily bring him away from the other enemies. And just be wary of his attacks. Okay, that was some lag there. That was very strange. But yeah, you can easily mess him up. And he will even drop titanium for me sometimes, and you can see without the hunger on, I got 16,016. So, come over here, I'll swap out dex and willpower, because why not? Doesn't really matter. Revenant's hunger on. Reset the missile, literally 2 feet away. And you'll come back this way again. Wide aggro range, come back at you. Let him come towards this corridor. Just to make sure if you don't want to aggro everyone else. Sometimes your partner will end up aggroing them. Okay, I blocked that one too. But yeah, mess them up right quick. And 19.2k right there. So every single run you'll be getting 19.2k haze from him. And you can just buy an endless amount of Queen Titanium that way. Other way to do it, you go over to the Crown of Sand entrance. So quite a ways before this point, not quite as difficult to get to, but around the earliest point that you'll be able to farm Queen Titanium, you can come to the Crown of Sand here. There are three big enemies shortly after you come off from the missile, and you can put some Revenant's Greed on and easily farm them over and over again for a chance for them to drop Queen Titanium if you haven't made it far enough into the game to be able to purchase it infinitely. And so I'll show you what these guys look like and how you might want to take them on. Originally I was just doing it with a one-handed sword. Two-handed sword works just as well. My character is a little bit overpowered for this area, but if you're like upper 90s, I'd say definitely by the time you're lower 100s you should have no problem with this place. And depending upon your skill level, heck, you could even be 80s, really, I guess. But yeah, definitely upper 90s, lower 100s. You should have no problem with this. But yeah, go ahead, throw your Revenant's Greed on, if you got it. And come over here as the first one. Okay, I wasn't ready for the stabby attack. Sorry, I'm using a blood veil that I just got today, so I still have to readjust to the parry timing. He didn't drop one, but sometimes you'll get unlucky, but typically you should get at least one drop from them every 2 to 3 runs. Sometimes you'll get lucky as well. And you'll get drops from them all the time. So I wasn't as lucky there, but I'm gonna just do it again right quick and show you guys what I mean, just so you can see for yourself that you for sure can come here and get clean titanium. And so here we are running the same thing again. Come on, swing. All right, running the same path again. And if you really want to, and you're pretty confident, you can also throw on your Revenant's Hunger here too. Get about 9k a pop from these guys. And I'm just getting really unlucky with these drops, I guess. Alright. That's a Harmonia Chrome. Okay, cool. Let's try this one more time. Hopefully this works out for us. Alright, now here we are on to our third run of it. And hopefully I should get some titanium from at least one of them here. Really, it's also just luck of the draw. He always flies so far past without attack. And then these guys are super easy to backstab, pretty easy to parry too because they're so slow. Condensed Slush Shard M, but it was showing everything you can get but what I want to show. Okay, you know what? Yeah, I'm just going to skip to a point where it actually drops some for us. So I'll be back in a moment. And there we have it, clean titanium, guys. That attack is really broken. I'd advise not even trying to parry that, because 9 times out of 10, it's just gonna be something really stupid. Because the hitboxing on it isn't even actually where you'd expect it to be. But yep, you can come through, farm these guys. Also, if you go down this path here, there are a couple enemies, but to the right, I'm pretty sure there's a ladder, and you go up that, and go forward a little ways, and there's a fourth one. So if you want to extend your search just a little bit, you can do that. Or go up this elevator on the left if you've got it unlocked, but if you're just coming to the area, you won't have that. Cool, yeah. You won't have that yet, so it's best to just do it this way. So there's clean titanium. If you do or don't have as far as the provisional government outskirts unlocked. But lastly, you guys need to see, right after you beat the Queen's Knight Reborn, there is a ladder, and once you go down that ladder, at the very bottom of it, I've already picked it up, but I'll show you guys where it's at the very bottom of it. You can't miss it. You'll get the Zero District Depths, and when you get that, you can go in and fight the Queen's Knight Reborn over and over again, just farming Queen Tungsten off of it. I'm not actually going to fight it in this video, because personally, I don't really like fighting the Queen's Knight or the Queen's Knight Reborn, but it's not really that bad of a boss fight. It's just something that I really don't like doing unless I have to. Just move straight on through this doorway here once you spawn in, and at the end of this corridor we should be coming up on a ladder straight there in front of us. And at the bottom of this ladder, from our left currently, but by the time we get down to our right, right here, right around here. So yeah, you should be able to get the Zero District Depths there. And once you have that, you'll want to make your way on into the depths. And press the wrong button, because I'm thinking of Dark Souls. Also, you get this here missile root in the crypt spire, and it's very useful because it's essentially vivification or using a vivifier, but you keep all your haze, you don't use ichor, and you don't have to use up an extra ability slot. And just throw it on your quick items, using it whenever you want. In a moment, I'm gonna take us back into home base, and you'll see that I've completed this depth, but then I'll go back in one more time just to show you guys that you can do it again and just farm the boss for some clean tungsten. It drops you times two, and that's enough to get a weapon to plus 10 every single time you beat the boss. And on top of that, not only do you get the tungsten, but you get haze as well as the thrill of just fighting a boss and getting good enough to the point where you know its moveset in and out, and it makes it a lot easier fighting other things for you because you fight that thing so many times that eventually you're just going to become desensitized to anything smaller or slower or weaker. But yeah, I'll be back in a second.
Honestly, I'll
Okay,
lead
and
the
so
way.
now we're
Just
over
tell me
here
where
at
we're going.
Davis, and you can see I have both Zero District and Void District. You can also see on Zero District all the things that are down here. The enemies here also frequently drop MJ310s.
Don't be
So,
overeager.
if you want to come down here, you can also farm them. Get yourself some MJ310. Go ahead and get those spicier gifts. Get them learned extra quick. And there you go. Work on that 50 gift and 150 gift master trophy. And you're golden. Literally, because 150 gifts, gold trophy. Alright, but we're gonna get into this depth, and then you saw there that I've 100% complete this before, and then I'll come in again just to show you how resets, and you
I'll
coming
be
back
with you.
this way, and there we have the boss again, sitting right in there for you. Now, you're not gonna be able to kill it and then come right back out to the missile and then kill it again. You actually have to physically leave the depth and then come back in, and it will respawn for you, and you can kill it over and over again to your heart's content. And that is your quickest way to go about getting Queen's tungsten, iron, steel, whatever you need. Honestly, I wouldn't even be too worried about iron because it drops so frequently throughout the game anyway that by the time you've got it available infinitely, you won't have to really worry about it much. And Queen Steel, the earliest to farm that and easiest is over in the Cathedral of Blood. And you can farm just about any enemy there you really want. Honestly, you could just do that first enemy once you run down the steps over and over again. And it helps you get used to those kinds of move sets, where the backstab is on them, parry timing, all of that. And you get yourself some Queen Steel while you're at it. And then you move on to the Crown of Sand. You got all the titanium you want. And by the time you get to the Provisional Government, you can infinitely farm anything you need, and once you beat the Queen's Knight Reborn there, you can come here, you can get the Zero District depth, come here, and fight the Queen's Knight Reborn over and over again for two tungsten every time you beat it. So, that is my guide to getting all the Queen's iron, steel, and tungsten you could possibly want, as well as a little extra tidbit on MJ310s. And there you have it. So, as usual, thank you all for watching. And if you have, make sure to rate, subscribe, comment, turn on notifications, maybe even share it with a friend. Do all that good stuff, and I will see you guys next time.